You know, one of the worst things in the world is dramatic irony. Don't you hate it when you're in a position where you feel something is right, you feel like something is the status quo, and all of a sudden you learn later on that that's really not the truth. But at the end of the day, you know, my own personal problems aside, we're in a position where we have some irony at our hands. But this is not that dramatic irony that I absolutely loathe. What we're looking at today is a little bit more of that situational irony, because a few days ago we made a video talking about how Kotkaniemi and Cole Caulfield were both doing incredibly well. We made that video a few days ago talking about Lucas Raymond and the two Montreal guys. It was a hell yeah kind of video, because all the guys that were featured in that video were coming off of very nice statistical performances in the day that we recorded that video. But it's ironic because a few days later we made a video talking about how Cole Caulfield was in an unfortunate situation, and that video was treated with a lot of, I don't even know what to call it. Some people were calling me on the comments saying that I was overreacting, even though the stuff that I was talking about in the video, if you actually watched it, I actually said that it's not really my place to complain, it's very nitpicky, but at the end of the day I feel like it needed to be said. We had some other people saying, yeah, you know what, it makes sense what you're talking about. The fact is he's not being used to the best of his ability with the Wisconsin Badgers, but at the end of the day, there's still a lot more for Caulfield to learn in the other parts of the game, not just goal scoring, which is a very fair point as well. But for Kotkaniemi, we have ourselves our very own unfortunate update for him too, a few days after he made that video talking about how he finally got himself 2 points on the board. So Jesperi Kotkaniemi, he's in a position where he is not performing to the standard that people thought he would be in the Finnish Liga, playing for his hometown Porin Asat. He's a guy who, at the current time of this recording, Monday, November 16th, 9:40 p.m. PST, has 3 points in 7 games played. That's not amazing compared to what people were talking about before he suited up, because if you remember when we talked about Kotkaniemi and his overall transfer to the Finnish Liga, some people in Finland were saying, yeah, this guy could probably get 2 points a game, this guy could probably be the first line center, be the number one power play guy, this guy could probably be the overall just top 1% of the players in the entire Finnish Liga. But that definitely has not been the case on the score sheet. He's been outscored by some very nice players who are also playing on that squad. Toronto Maple Leafs prospect Ronnie Hirvonen has been outscoring him, which makes a lot of people think that Hirvonen is better. But we have ourselves what was an article on The Athletic written by Zarpon Basu, talking about just exactly why Kotkaniemi isn't really doing all too well. And I think this overall perspective kind of eases the mind a little bit. Because, sure, even though I've made my videos talking about how Kotkaniemi has been getting points, he's been getting 2 points sometimes, at the end of the day, he's still at 3 points in 7 games played. And the Porin Asat most recently came off of a 9-1 loss against the Lukko hockey team, and that was absolutely devastating. So there certainly is a whole bunch of stuff to take a look at for the Porin Asat, Jesperi Kotkaniemi as a whole, and what exactly this means for his long-term development. So, going over onto the article on The Athletic, the title is this: Jesperi Kotkaniemi's slow start in Finland shows how he has evolved in Montreal. And the article is indeed behind a paywall, so we're not going to be reading this article in itself, but instead we're going over onto ProHockeyRumors.com because they summarize what exactly is said on this article, so I'll go off of it right here. Also, nice little plug, Kotkaniemi gets a hat trick in this gameplay, which is very nice to coordinate with the kind of video topic that we have on our hands. This is what Arpon Basu says about Kotkaniemi. He is currently playing for his hometown team in the Finnish Liga for the Porin Asat. The forward went scoreless in his first 4 games before getting his first point. He now has 3 assists in 7 games, but is still looking for his first goal. While the numbers aren't there, Basu writes that Kotkaniemi is still trying to adjust to Finland's top league, where every team they play is completely focused on him, something he hasn't had to deal with in his 2 years in the NHL. Adjusting back to the Liga after 2 years on North America's smaller rinks also has been an adjustment for the player who was enjoying dueling hits out in the NHL. That's much harder to do in the Liga, where the larger rinks lead to a hit potentially taking him out of a play, meaning he can't really work on that part of his game all too much. And we'll just hold things off. I want to go over that last part here first and foremost, the hitting. Kotkaniemi to me wasn't really a guy who I thought was a physical, kind of body-checking kind of guy until we really saw that style of his game developing in the postseason. And I think everybody kind of knows what I'm talking about. Kotkaniemi got ejected from one of the games against the Flyers because he ended up dishing out a hit where he left the ice, he got the guy into the boards, it was ugly, and Kotkaniemi was just straight up gone. And it's kind of funny because the Habs actually won that game. If you were there for our live stream that we did during those games, you could definitely see the surprise on my face when they ended up scoring 5 goals. But Kotkaniemi has been in a position where he's allowed other parts of his game in the NHL to really start blossoming. That two-way style, that physical style, it really started showing itself off, and we started seeing a lot more swagger with Kotkaniemi against the Flyers specifically. But this point of him being the top dog, the number one guy in the food chain, the top 1%, as I labeled it before in the video, in the Finnish Liga, does exist. At the end of the day, Kotkaniemi is playing in a position where if you swapped out Hirvonen for Kotkaniemi in the playoffs, I guess, just for the sake of making that whole Hirvonen-Kotkaniemi comparison, let's say it was Roni Hirvonen playing for the Montreal Canadiens in that series against Philly, do you think he is as successful as Kotkaniemi was, scoring some clutch goals, making some big plays? I personally don't think so. Roni Hirvonen is a guy who just is a matter of circumstance, playing a little bit of an easier role and not being the number one target like Kotkaniemi is. I hate to make it all about Roni Hirvonen because I know Habs fans probably just don't want to hear that name anymore, but it is an argument that you have to make because Kotkaniemi is indeed the guy who many people know was supposed to be that big-time goal-scoring, playmaking offensive threat, both ends of the ice, that the Liga was holding on to when they got him back. So, for Basu to say that it's kind of the reason why he's not getting any points because teams are overloading on him, hey, it makes sense to me. That certainly is something that Kotkaniemi is going to need to adjust and get over that hump in order to become the guy who many people believe he can be at the NHL level. Because hey, we saw Nick Suzuki as a guy who was kind of clobbered over in the Philadelphia series and he was still pretty good. Kotkaniemi, not so much. There was still Deneau, there was still Domi sharing the load of the center core over there, but in the Finnish Liga, it does make sense to understand the idea that Kotkaniemi is that guy, the big number one scoring threat, the NHL graduate who is made his way back onto a Finnish team, and who was coming off of a really good AHL performance and a nice final few games against the Flyers. So, there certainly is a lot to unpack here, but if you're Jesperi Kotkaniemi and you're in a position where you're faced with these hurdles, just getting over them is a very great sign of growth, and if he's able to do that, then we will be able to see a Kotkaniemi who might be able to showcase those growth development traits sooner rather than later, because at the end of the day, you know, he's still 20, but by the time he's 25, he's 26, he's 28 years old in his prime. These are the years where we're going to see whether or not Kotkaniemi has that capacity to overcome being one of the top targets of the other teams. He's already getting a first-hand experience at what that's like in the Finnish Liga. He hasn't seen that in Montreal yet, but if he develops in the way that people know he can, he will see that sooner rather than later. So I would rather see him struggling now in the Finnish Liga and actually having to have the reins of being a number one guy thrusted over his shoulder than wait a few more years before the NHL gives him that opportunity and that overall duty over here in Montreal. So that wraps up our talk here on Kotkaniemi. It is a different kind of video, I will say. Even though we did brand things the same way, an unfortunate Cole Caulfield update a few days ago, and then an unfortunate Jesperi Kotkaniemi update today, it's just this one is a lot less surprising. Because at the end of the day, the Caulfield one, a lot of people kind of got upset at that because he is still at a point of game. And at face value, it could look like I'm complaining, and it could look like I'm not being acknowledging of what exactly he is doing, even though he is at a point per game and he is at the same pace that he was last year. But there are some things that I thought were at least noteworthy to the point that I wanted to make it, because, you know, the stuff that we talked about, it's not stuff that I think is ideal, and I did say that in the video, you know, it's nitpicky, I get that, I still acknowledge that he's doing well, but he was not being played in the power play right, and he's playing with some whack line mates, and he's not really getting that opportunity to be the goal-scoring machine Cole Caulfield, goal Caulfield, as you could say, that he was last year, and sure, you could say it's all for development purposes, but it's been 2 games and the season is only 12 games long, so that's a 6th of the season there. For Kotkaniemi, it's different because everybody kind of knew from the get-go after his first 4 games after not getting any points that something was up. So I guess I'm not really looking forward to this one in terms of the overall response, because I know it's going to be flaming down there. The more cynical Habs fans talking about how this guy's a bust, and Red Wings fans and other team fans joining in on that, while other Habs fans trying to defend him. At the end of the day, I do still think that Kotkaniemi is going to be a good NHL player, but the growing pains have been a lot more prevalent with his development path than other third overall picks, I would say, in the past few years. So talk to me in the comments what you think about Kotkaniemi and this whole unfortunate situation. Hope you enjoyed this video. I Trolls 99, and bye.